Hello, everyone, and welcome to Seeker Vogue. Today, we'll be looking at creating a database in SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server. We'll look at how you create a database and how you also create tables inside those databases and also inserting data inside a table. In previous videos, we took a look at installing SQL Server, we took a look at patching SQL Server, installing SSMS. And also upgrading edition of SQL Server from evaluation to developer. And the reason we do all of these things, or the reason you do all of these things, would be because of the databases that would be created or stored in that server. Before we jump in, let me quickly explain what a database and a table are. A database is like a digital filing cabinet. It stores and organizes data so that you can easily find, update and manage the data. Now, inside that cabinet, you have tables, kind of like individual folders. So those tables are like individual folders or spreadsheets, just like you have Excel sheets. Each of the table holds specific types of data in the form of rows and columns, the same way we'll have inside an Excel sheet. For example, if you are storing information about people, you might have a table with columns like ID, first name, last name, and date of birth. And each row would be for one person or one person's record. That's how this is like. So now we'll go ahead to create a database and we'll create tables and we'll insert data into the table. First, we'll go ahead and do this using the graphical user interface, which is GUI. After that, we'll go ahead and do the same thing using scripts. So let's go ahead and start. We can see I have my Management Studio up, SSMS. And if we look in here right now for the databases, we see that I do not have any user databases. I only have the system databases. There are no user databases here. So to create a database in GUI, I would right click on database, click new, and with this interface, I will give that database a name. In this case, let's say DemoDB. And for the owner, I'm going to leave this as default. It's not recommended that you use SA, but depending on the application that I'll be using the database, a specific service account can be assigned here as the owner. Now, when it comes to this other information we see here, this would be for the data and this would be for the log file. We can see the initial size. Usually, it's recommended that for your data, you want to create that database having an idea of the size that it will be. So you would use that instead of using a smaller size and then your file begins to auto grow several times, which will create a lot of VLFs, which we call virtual log files. Virtual log files is a story for another day. I'll do a separate video on that. And you can hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you know when I post and you know more about that. But for this, I'm just going to leave the size as the default since we're just doing a test and this is going to be a very small database. Now, for auto growth, well, you can actually change the size. If you click on here, you can change. You see, I can highlight and change what the sizes are. Now, for auto growth, you can also change this so that your database can grow if it needs to grow. You can choose for it to grow by in percentages or by specific amount, which is recommended. But I'm going to leave this as the default and I'll cancel out of here. If we scroll towards the right some more, we see the location where our log and our data file will be stored. These can also be changed if we don't want them to be this, but this is the default based on how this SQL Server was installed or configured. So we see that information right here. If you come to options, we can decide the recovery model that this would be. And if this is going to be for a specific application and they have collation requirements, you can change the collation here. Otherwise, it's just going to use the default based on how SQL Server was installed on this machine. Now, compatibility level, we can also, based on the application, you can also change this, but I'm going to leave this to the latest, which we have. And there are also a couple of features here that can be tweaked based on the application or what we want to use this for. But I don't have to do that, so I'm going to leave all of these as is. If we come down to file groups, we can add file groups for better organization. I am also going to leave this as is because I don't want to add any file group. That's going to be a discussion for another day. So I have all of these sets. I can go ahead and click on the create button to create the database. I can also go ahead to script this out to a query window so we'll see how it looks like. And then I would click on create or click on OK, and this would create that database. We see right here now we have a database here, DemoDB, the database we created. And this is the script that created that database based on what we did. We don't necessarily need this. I can delete all of this because we can still create the database using the script. If I right-click on the database and delete it, and I'll close. And refresh. We don't have that database there anymore. We can see the database is gone. We only have our system database in there. I can go ahead and use this same script that we scripted out, execute this, and we will get a database in here. So if I refresh and we expand database, we have DemoDB again. If I go ahead to delete this still and have this deleted and remove all of this information and just say create database and name of the database as DemoDB, I'll delete this. And if I go ahead to click on create, we see it's still going to create the database for us. And if I expand here, we have our database. Now, why is this? The reason is without specifying anything, we're still able to create the database and it will carry those same things we just took a look at, the file size, the location where the data file will be stored, the location where the log file will be stored and everything. And it's getting that information from what we call this, the ModelDB, which is this database right here. However, this ModelDB is configured, whenever you create a database, it's going to take those properties from here. Unless you specifically specify how that database should be, it would get its properties from here. For instance, if I go ahead to right click on here and click on the properties of this database, and I want to compare it to the properties of the model database, I'll put this way and I'll put the other one this way. If we compare everything between these databases, we would see that they are the same because it's getting its structure from the model DB. That is why it's very important for us to configure our model DB whenever we install SQL Server for the way our databases should be like when we create, if we don't want to specify certain conditions for those databases. Let's close this out and let's go create a table inside our database now that we have a database. Now, to create a table, we want to create this table inside that database that we just created, which is DemoDB. I will go into this DemoDB and expand. Click on this plus button to expand. And if I expand the tables, we would see here that we don't have any user tables. So I'm going to right click right on tables and new. I will click on table. This gives me a place to manually type in information for my table. So for the column names, I'll use, let's say we do ID for the column name. And the data type, I want it to be integer. And I don't want to allow null, so I'm going to uncheck that. And for the next column, I want to use first name. And I'm going to use, let's use here nvarchar. Let's go with nvarchar 50. And I will come to the next row for last name. I would also use, let's use the same nvarchar 50. And what else would I want? Date of birth, DOB. And for this, I want to use dates, right? So now we have our table structured the way we want it to look. We have all the columns we want. We have the data types. And now we can go ahead. I want to go ahead and make this right click on this to make this the primary key. And I'm done creating this simple table. Now to save the table, because this is not saved yet, we can come up here and click on this save icon right here to save. You can use Ctrl X on the keyboard. You can also right click right here to go ahead and save. So I'll go ahead and click on this save. And then we're able to put in, when you click on save, it will ask you for the name of the table. So now I'll type in the name for the table, info. I'll click on OK. Now, if I refresh here, we didn't have that before. We can see we have a table called person info under the DBO schema. All we just did right now was to create a table. We haven't put data into the table. So if I right click on this table, I can actually get the script to create the table. I can query this to a new window. And we would see the script that created this table. So this is the script that created the table. So I can go ahead and delete this. We use the demo DB and we created the table, right? This is the script from that table that was created. So now that we've done this, let's go put some data inside the table. And we'll go ahead and do this with GUI. So if we right click on that table that was created and we see edit top 200 rows, so we can see this is what we created. Remember the columns we chose, the ID, first name, last name, date of birth. Now we can go ahead and start putting data into the table manually, like inserting data into that table that we created. So for the ID, let me say one. And if I click on tab, you would see this here letting us know that the value in that cell has changed. So for the first name, I'll go ahead to say John, last name Doe, date of birth. Let's just give a date of birth, January 15th, right? And I would come to the second line and I'll do this. Let's go ahead and insert like five records in here. Let's say Jane Doe. Or let's actually use Smith here. And for the last one, let's go ahead to say David. And for last name, let's just say William. And date of birth would say 1995. Let's say just give anything. So now we've put data into our table manually. If I go ahead to close this tab, it should save the data into the table. So I'll refresh. If I refresh this table and I right click again to go back to edit the table, edit top 200 rows, we see that the information is right there in the table. So we can actually now query this table. If I say select top 1000 rows, we can see the information that we just put in there. I'm creating this. So this is how you would create a table using GUI and also insert data into the table. Now that we've taken a look at how to do this, creating a database and creating a table, inserting data into the table using GUI, we can as well go ahead and drop all of these. I'll delete the database and we can do this using our scripts. We already have the script that we use for creating the table right here. And for the database, we already have a create database script right here. So I'll go ahead to delete this database. I need to delete everything inside. Now that that is gone, if I refresh and we come and check on our database, we see here that we don't have the database anymore. We just have our system database. So I'll go ahead to, let me copy this and put everything in one place. And so now we're going to create a table. Our database is created. If we refresh, we can see the database there. And now we can highlight this and go ahead and create our table. Execute. And we'll refresh. And our table is in here. We can see DBO, the person info. And now we can insert data into this table using the script. I have a script right here that I put together. Okay, I would use this to go ahead and insert data into it, and then we will read from this. So insert the data into the table. And then we can read from that table. We have the same information. So this is how you create a database and a table in SQL Server and also insert data into the table with GUI and with T-SQL. If this video was helpful to you, please hit the like button and subscribe. And turn on the notification bell so you know when I post. Thank you for your time today. See you in the next video.